Vance Joy joins us now. Great to have you here.
It's good to be back.
Touring. Nice to be back in the country.
It's really nice to be back. I'm excited to tour. I'm very kind of nervous and apprehensive, but I'm rehearsing now with the band. So everything should be perfect and ready to go.
This was your latest single we just heard there from your new album, In Our Own Sweet Time. That was an album you wrote in lockdown, yeah?
Yeah.
Not bad from a little lockdown album. Like, yeah. Oh, my God.
Yeah, it was challenging, you know, especially early days. I really kind of gave up on, well, pretty much immediately I was like, OK, I'm not going to release an album for a while. Maybe, you know, I'll just you know, see what happens. But then not long after the first kind of 5 months of lockdown, during that time I kind of tried to do whatever I could and made the best of the situation, and so I got on Zoom and wrote some songs and ended up writing a couple of songs that I was really proud of, and then that kind of snowballed into an album.
Is it harder to be creative when you're in a circumstance like that where you're not seeing people and doing normal things?
Yeah, that's what I thought was going to be the case, because I was so, like, the input was so limited that I was like, where am I going to get inspiration from? And it was kind of funny, like, I was so starved for inspiration that after a few weeks, I got on a Zoom with some friends and we did a quiz night. And that the energy I got from seeing people on the screen after that quiz night, I was like, got to the piano and I was like writing a theme song for the quiz. And I was like, I'm back, you know, like I can write songs. Even if it's just a quiz theme song jingle, I can, you know, do this.
I thought you were going to say you're so starved with inspiration that Scott Morrison on the ukulele was actually something you wrote towards.
I was like, I'm dusting it off again. He's inspired me. No.
The film clip's lovely, by the way. Cedar is stunning. It's a classic Vance Joy film clip, by which I mean it seems that you're just appearing less and less in them.
Yeah.
You're not in this one at all.
Yeah.
Why are they not letting you do your own film?
I don't know. I say, give me some lines. Let me do like a Taylor Swift like mini movie inside the middle of them. And they're like, no, no. No, I think with this one it was, we did a few, and my friend Brad, and that's his partner Meg, and their dog, and I forgot the dog's name.
Oh, but the dog's watching too. Oh my God!
But they were doing a trip across Canada from one side to the other, and Brad, who's been our photographer for years, was like, I'd love the opportunity to make a clip for you. And I said, well, look, you're doing this trip, we'll, you know, take a really special camera, a really good one, and make the clip you've always wanted to make. And so,
yeah, but it's a pattern, mate. You're not in them. Do they not trust you?
They. I wasn't in the first Riptide clip, because there was a really cool clip, and they were like, the record label was like, you know, we want you like to camera singing, like, so people know who you are and stuff. And then eventually, I started being in clips, and then this one, I feel like I was in the Missing Piece film clip, and I was really proud of that performance. And then I was in the
wait. You're only in the back of the car. You weren't doing much.
Yeah, actually, that's true. Right?
I don't know why they don't use you more, because your acting is extraordinary. We had you on the Carrie and Tommy radio show this afternoon, and you did a staged walkout. You cracked the shits and you stormed out. And honestly, it was so believable.
Is it here?
Hey, bro, you're touring around the country. This is exciting.
Yeah, yep.
Do you want to tell your voice that you're excited?
Oh, last time I was here, you guys pulled a prank on me. I've had people coming up to me saying, like, oh, my God, how gullible are you? Like, you fell for that. I don't know if I even can continue the chat. Like, you cut me deep last time. Nicole Kidman was, like, my childhood hero. And, I don't know. Should we just...
Oh my God, what's happened? I'm like, he is the nicest guy in Australia. Even if he was grumpy, he would pretend to be okay.
That's not the way it felt in the room. I felt like I was giving like a really convincing performance, but I look like I'm trying to remember what to say. It's not very realistic.
Very lame storm out.
Yeah, it was. Thanks for asking.
I can give you some lessons on storming.
What's the backstory? Why were you trying to be grumpy?
Well, it was. Carrie pulled a prank on me. We were both in London and I came on the show, and she told me that, because I kind of had told her that my childhood hero and my like celebrity crush was Nicole Kidman. And so that Carrie and Tommy wrote a letter from Nicole Kidman, and they gave it to me, and in the moment I was like, I don't know, I just believed it. And then immediately they're like,
you read it, are you teared up?
Yeah,
it's a very cool radio program, that one.
Yeah, it's cruel. And then I felt very silly, but it was also very funny. So I got pranked when I was little, that's why, because when I was about 8 years old, I had a Nicole Kidman crush, and my auntie wrote a fake letter with a cut out from the magazine of Nicole Kidman, and she's like, Nicole's written to you. Even then I knew it wasn't real, but I kind of played along just for her. So,
well, you know what? We've got a welcome to the show. It's Nicole Kidman. No, that's sad.
Very mean you are.
Oh, he knows I love him.
Hey, there's a bunch of great songs on the album. One, I love Looking at Me Like That. Which is a bit of a romantic song.
Yes, yes.
That's the most unromantic way to say it.
We're wrapped up. We've got to do it quick. But yeah. Does that mean that your things are going well with a girlfriend? Is that still
going well? Yeah, that one is a romantic one. And everything is going good. And she's coming to Australia shortly, the first time in Oz. So I'm looking forward to being tour guide.
You're touring at the end of the week. What are you missed about being out on the road?
I love my band. We've got a really good band lineup, and it's kind of like the original band. Like, we played our first show in October in 2012 at the Workers Club, and Jono, who was the original bass player, and Chris, who was the first guy we ever had on keys, we're all back together, and we're down at the Bakehouse rehearsing now.
That's not the Workers Club. We should point out.
That's not the Workers Club. That was 100 people. But
I'm actually offended that you haven't given me free tickets for any of your shows. In fact, I can't do this anymore.
No, of course not. Hey,
I'm out.
He's very good at it.
Head to our website for details on Vance Joy's Long Way Home tour. It's always a pleasure. Would you please thank Vance Joy?